With all of the talk going on about AI right now, I think there's a big storm brewing that's only beginning to percolate, and that is a massive worldwide discussion we're about to have about AI and privacy. Right now, it feels to me like AI is in an almost newborn state. The companies are going wild with experimentation, and users are all giddy playing with these new toys and figuring out the new things we can make them do. But it might be worth it to step back for a moment and just think about what we're doing with this. Because every time we open up a new window to have a conversation with an AI chatbot, we might fall under the illusion that we're just having a conversation with something that feels like a person but has vast resources beyond what any one person could do. And within that conversation, it's very easy for us to give away information freely about our personal lives, our business, and other things like that. And this is something we want to tread very, very carefully with. I want to take a brief look at the question of what would happen if AI leaked personal information or got hacked and led to the release of personal information. It's a little bit different than the previous generation of social media privacy norms. When you interact with social media, you're normally doing it to be social, so that it can be noticed, so that it can be interacted with. Most of us are aware that if we were to leave a comment somewhere on the internet to the effect of, "Hey, I'm going on vacation next week," that would probably not be a wise thing from a security standpoint. And just this week, there's been a handful of developments in the area of AI and privacy that have really made me think, so I want to talk about them for a minute. First, let's talk about Adobe Creative Cloud. Earlier this week, Adobe quietly revised their terms and conditions of their Creative Cloud products. When customers of programs like Photoshop loaded up the program, they were forced to agree to new terms and conditions that included terminology that anything they were working on that was stored in Adobe Creative Cloud could be scanned and used as training material for anyone that Adobe wanted to align themselves with. Adobe gave people no way of opting out of this new policy. So the choice was either agree to it or don't launch Photoshop. As soon as this was noticed by users, it started a bit of a five-alarm fire across the internet, because it really is ludicrous that Adobe would claim that right to be able to scan everything you're working on using the program and use it for their purposes. Now, this caused such a furor that Adobe did backtrack on this. So first, they responded by saying, no, we've had a policy like this for many years, it's no big deal. And then when they realized the issue was not going to go away with that, they had to go a level deeper and actually start to consider changing it. All the time claiming transparency, yada, yada, yada. You know how these things go. The latest statement at the time I'm making this video reads like this. The focus of this update was to be clearer about the improvements to our moderation processes that we have in place. Given the explosion of generative AI and our commitment to responsible innovation, we've added more human moderation to our content submission review processes. If you parse that statement, it's helpful but not precise enough. So then they went a step further to say that Adobe does not train Firefly Gen AI models on customer content. And they assured customers that Adobe will never assume ownership of a customer's work. Adobe hosts content to enable customers to use our applications and services. Customers own their own content, and Adobe does not assume any ownership of customer work. They then promised that they would clarify this further in the terms of service. So temporarily, at least, this issue is at bay with Adobe, but it's happening other places across the internet too. The next big company that tried to pull something like this is Dropbox, which arguably might be even more infuriating than what Adobe was trying to pull, because Dropbox is effectively a file storage and sharing service. And because it integrates deeply with the OS, I think it's very much assumed by pretty much every Dropbox user out there that when you put a file in Dropbox, it's basically kind of like an extension of your own hard drive, except in the cloud. There is no implication that when you put something in Dropbox, that it would go anywhere except where you say it can go. But Dropbox made news recently when customers started noticing there was the third-party AI button buried deep in the settings. The official explanation was that Dropbox uses artificial intelligence from third-party partners so you can work faster in Dropbox. It also says that Dropbox works only with technology partners that we have vetted, and that it's deleted within 30 days from their servers. And as far as I can tell, it looks like this setting is enabled by default for most or all of Dropbox's paying customers. So I have obvious concerns about this, because there's all kinds of examples of files that I might want to put in Dropbox, but I assume they're completely private, and it seems like they're not. So as best I can tell, Dropbox did retreat a little bit on this. They said, hey, any customer confusion about this is on us, and we'll take a turn to make sure that all this is abundantly clear. Now, the official company line of both Adobe and Dropbox is that they're innovating and trying to make each of their products better. They're trying to serve you better. They're trying to learn you better so that their product can be more powerful. Up until this era, this hasn't really been a problem. But in my opinion, it does cross a line when your personal data is being used and goes outside the bounds of where you would expect it to go. I've even started to see this happening within the music industry. I've spoken before about Musiversal, the online budget session recording service that lets you easily contract remote musicians to play on your scores or songs. Musiversal is well known for updating their terms and conditions about every week, but a recent revision to their terms of service, at least it's up there today as I make this video, includes the following clauses. Musiversal reserves the right to use musical recordings for promotional purposes, that's okay, as well as for machine learning purposes and training of music creation algorithms to improve the quality of all our final products. The last part of that phrase is a throwaway, because when they talk about improving the quality of their final products, that's a very vague legal term, because what constitutes improving is entirely a matter of opinion. The real meat of this passage is the machine learning purposes part. As you may know, many of the generative AI platforms train on large language models, and what that means is they need to vacuum up large, vast quantities of data so that their algorithms can analyze them, so that when the user goes to ChatGPT or Udio or whatever the service is, it has a wealth of knowledge of source material that it can pull from. Now, there's a very serious fight going on in the world right now between that demand and copyright. That is a very serious topic that I do want to talk about, but I'm going to save that for separate videos. For now, it's enough to just consider that if you were to engage Musiversal to record some instruments on your track, those session files don't just belong to you, but Musiversal might choose to send that to other companies in what would presumably be additional income for them. Now, yes, all of the companies that I've talked about will go to great lengths to say that all your data is anonymized, that there's no way it'll lead directly back to you. We can believe those for now, until the system breaks somewhere. My entire point of making this video is really to shine a spotlight on privacy, because most of us have lived our entire lives with some assumed level of privacy. But now it's starting to feel like some of the services that we rely on might be coming in through the back door to get some of our data. And while they're walking out the back door, they're saying, no, it's just so that we can serve you better. One last mention of something that happened literally just today, as Apple hosted their WWDC keynote, which spotlighted a lot of the things that Apple is doing in the artificial intelligence area. Now, I view Apple as a company that has really kept privacy as a number one priority. So I find them to be among the more trustworthy companies out there. But they did also say that they were partnering with OpenAI, ChatGPT, but only via a specific gateway. Meaning, if you ask your Apple device a question that your device thinks would be better suited for ChatGPT, then it will ask you if you want to ask ChatGPT that question, and it will go fetch the answer for you. And Apple claims that that entire transaction is anonymized, doesn't even require an account to set up. My own reaction was that I tended to believe them that far, at least. But it did lead Elon Musk to immediately denounce the move, because he did not believe that that data could be effectively anonymized. It seems like he might have hit the roof a little bit, even saying that if Apple integrated OpenAI at an OS level, which is not quite exactly what they did, that he would have all his employees have to check their Apple devices at the door. So I think he's being a little bit dramatic. It's also worth pointing out that Musk is also simultaneously continuing to develop his own AI algorithm called Grok. It's built into Twitter, X. So there is a bit of a conflict of interest there. But the reason I bring up that reaction today is because it underscores the importance of our need for reasonable levels of privacy, specifically in the tools that we might use every day. I found myself thinking, well, if Dropbox is sending my files to who knows where, what about my backup service, Backblaze? I immediately fired off an email to Backblaze wanting to investigate this further, and I received an immediate response that they never share users' files anywhere outside the company. They are all encrypted, and I did have a read of their terms of service and confirmed there was nothing like this in there. So where do we go from here? Clearly, I'm making this video just as the fire is starting to light around this issue. My hope is that people like you and me and the world will take notice of these examples of Adobe and Dropbox especially, and nip this one in the bud before it becomes a huge problem. Because when we buy a computer or a phone and we start using a particular app, and as we interact with that app, we shouldn't have to worry about the consequences of what would happen if other people stole the stuff we were doing in that app. We really don't want to open the door of companies taking advantage of our privacy expectations. So I made this video quick and impromptu because I came across all these stories in a short amount of time. I'm sure there are more out there. If you know about more, please put them in the comments down below, because this is clearly something we're all going to have to keep a close eye on. Please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you on the next one.